hotels to avoid the disease spreading, even though they may not actually be infected. Testing of the remaining 40,000 sheep in the area continues.
Led from the hills for slaughter, the cull which began on the Brecon Beacons last night resumed this morning. Animals herded into pens hidden from public view. The killing is taking place behind a screen of trees. A convoy of lorries is on site to take the carcasses away to be rendered. 4,000 animals will be destroyed after tests showed they'd been exposed to the foot and mouth virus. For some farmers here, it means the end of a life's work.
We've basically realised that we're going to lose everything today in this cull. There are no more animals left on our farm. No sheep, no cattle. It's the end of our line of our farm at the moment. It's the end of the pride of the breeding of our sheep that can't be replaced.
The animals here have been bred for generations to know their territory. That accumulated knowledge is being lost, and there could be worse to come. More sheep are being tested to see if they've been exposed to the virus.
As the cull here continues, other farmers wait anxiously for the results of those tests. They're expected in the next few days and could mean that thousands more animals will have to be slaughtered. Daniel Bircher, BBC News, on the Brecon Beacons.
It's one of the busiest weekends of the year for travel, with nearly 2 million people expected to head abroad and thousands more heading for the coasts here. Weather forecasters are predicting that temperatures this weekend will be hotter than in Hawaii. The south of England is expected to reach a high of 30 degrees centigrade, but there is a price. Thousands of people have been caught up in traffic jams, with long delays reported on the M5 in Somerset and the A30 in Cornwall. Police in Northern Ireland have discovered several hundred petrol bombs in the Glenbrinn area of Belfast. The find follows a night of disturbances in which a man was shot and injured during clashes between loyalists and Republicans in the north of the city.
Council workers clear away the debris after another night of sectarian clashes in North Belfast. This is where the staunchly Republican Ardoyne district interfaces with loyalist areas. Last night, as the pubs closed, teenagers from both sides pelted each other with bricks, bottles, and then petrol bombs. In a more sinister twist, gunmen opened fire. This man sustained a minor facial injury. It's thought he may have been hit by a ricocheting bullet. As usual, each side blamed the other for starting the trouble. In Northern Ireland terms, last night's trouble was fairly minor. What's worrying security chiefs and politicians is the increasing use of firearms in these exchanges. If someone's killed, then what's been sporadic, isolated skirmishes could spiral out of control. Tom Coulter, BBC News, North Belfast.
The couple who tried to adopt twins using an internet adoption agency now look like losing their home. Alan and Judith Kilshaw have agreed to the voluntary repossession of their house in North Wales. They're facing costs of at least £60,000 after they lost a legal challenge to keep the children. Heavy earth moving equipment has been brought in to help contain the flow of lava from Mount Etna in Sicily. Workers are using bulldozers to try to divert the lava away from tourist facilities. Europe's most active volcano has been erupting for more than a week, and experts say there's no sign yet of it ending. More than 15 million votes were cast to decide this year's winner of the Big Brother game show. The overall winner, Brian Dowling, an air steward from Ireland, emerged victorious after polling 1.5 million more votes than hairdresser Helen Adams. And that's it. There are news bulletins every hour on BBC News 24, but I'll be back with more news at 5:15 on BBC One.
Hello there. You don't need to hop on a plane in search of warm sunshine. Plenty of that to come, especially across England and Wales. And already temperatures in Gravesend as high as 27 Celsius, the warmest place in the country. Southern areas will hang on to this very warm weather well into next week. Further north, it'll soon turn cooler and fresher. May well be a bit of rain for a time, but then eventually temperatures start to recover here as we move in towards the middle of next week. Now, it's only July, but already the football season starts in Scotland. Coverage on BBC Radio 5 Live. And it looks like there'll be a lot of cloud in Scotland for today. It'll always be brighter as you head towards Edinburgh and also for the Dundee Derby. Now you can see the amount of cloud that's spilling down from the northwest, also affecting parts of Northern Ireland. But for England and Wales, very little cloud around at all. It looks like being another glorious sunny day. Very hot weather though for sporting events this weekend. The big race meeting today is at Ascot, the King George. Hot sunshine here. Remember, that sun is very strong. Temperatures, well, could be up to around 29 or 30 across inland parts of southern England. If that's a bit too hot for you, then head for the coast. There will be some cooler sea breezes here. Now, tonight's going to be a warm night, but changes are on the way for tomorrow. Some cooler, fresher air coming in across Scotland and Northern Ireland behind this very weak weather frontier. The winds will be picking up too, may introduce one or two showers towards the end of the day. That very weak weather front beginning to fizzle out as it moves its way southwards in towards Northern England, just really a band of clouds. Still plenty of sunshine in the south, a very warm, hot day, 30 or 31 degrees quite likely. So cover up if you're heading to Brands Hatch for the World Superbike Championship there. Lots of sunshine. And similar sort of temperatures across southern parts of England as we move in towards the beginning of next week. We may well find some thicker cloud bringing some rain across parts of Northern Ireland, in towards parts of Scotland as well. That really does fizzle out though as we move into Tuesday, just a band of cloud slipping in towards central areas by then. Maybe a little more cloud across southern parts of England on Tuesday, but still very warm, temperatures of 27 or 28. Similar sort of temperatures across the Channel into Paris for the end of the Tour de France. There are lots of sunshine. Very warm as well for the motor racing in Germany, just the risk of one or two showers here. We also have some showers across many central parts of Europe over the next few days. As you head further south though, more warm sunshine to come. That's it. I'll see you tomorrow.
Tonight on BBC One. At 7:30, the National Lottery winning lines with the National Lottery Thunderball and Lottery Extra Draws live. At 9, Robert Lindsay's an amateur detective.
You're out of your league.
Caught in the middle.
A properly screwed up, unhappy adult.
Of two families at war.
Stop the fight!
But will he use his brains?
Better talk to me now.
Or brawn.
You beat him at his own game.
To keep the peace. Hawkins, new drama. Tonight on BBC One.
Athletics Championships, Friday at 1:30 a.m. on BBC One.
Now on BBC One, Grandstand with John Inverdale.